Greetings, this is Pastor Linda with a prayer for today. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and forgive their sin and heal their land." Lord, that's my prayer for today, God, that you would, that our country and that, Lord, everybody would humble themselves. Lord, I humble myself and I... Lord, I looked up that word humble, and it means to be humble, to be subdued, to be brought down, to be low, to be under, to be brought into subjection, to subdue, to be subdued. And that reminded me in the scripture in Matthew 21:44. It says, "He who falls on the stone will be broken, and on whomever it falls, they will be ground him to powder." In other words, it's our choice that we come to God and humble ourselves. We have to willingly come to the stone, which is Jesus, the rock. And Jesus is either a rock of offense to people who reject him, or he is the stone that we can, he's our refuge, our fortress, our God in whom we trust. He's our secret place, our hiding place. He protects us. We're hidden in Christ in God. So we have to humble ourselves under his mighty hand and then pray and seek his face and turn from our wicked ways. So when we humble ourselves and we pray, we ask God, forgive us for our wicked ways. We say, God, without you, we can do nothing. Jesus, we need you. We fall on our face before you. Turn from our wicked ways. And Lord, you say you will hear from heaven and forgive our sin and heal our land. So, Father, I pray today, I intercede and intervene, to mediate, Lord, to intercede, to pray, Father, for our country, that you would have mercy upon our country, God, and save our country, save our people, save our children, God, and from all the perversion, Lord God. And, Father, in the Old Testament, in Isaiah 1:12, you said, "When you come to appear before me, who has required this from your hand to trample my courts?" In other words, they were coming to God's courts and they weren't honoring his courts and his blood and his blood covenant. In fact, in Hebrews, it tells us that we are not to trample the blood of Christ. And again, that's... the blood was what they used. They had to sprinkle the blood onto the, onto the altar. And the blood was commanded. It was necessary, for without the shedding of blood, there was no forgiveness. And you can see that right here in Hebrews 9, verses 22. And it says in Leviticus 17:11, without the shedding of blood, there's no forgiveness or no atonement. So Jesus had to shed his blood. So he went to all that work. If you just read Hebrews 9, 10, and 11, he was our sacrifice. He was offered one time for our sins for all. For by one offering, he perfected all time those who are sanctified. So he did all this for us through his blood, by his blood, the blood of Jesus. So that why? Well, it says, if we go on sinning willfully after we receive the knowledge of the truth, there's no longer remains a sacrifice for sin. In other words, if we just continue in our wickedness after we receive Jesus and we say, God, forgive me for my sins, and receive Jesus, the rock, but you just trample, it says, how much sore punishment do you think he will deserve who trampled underfoot the Son of God and has regarded as unclean the blood of the covenant by which he was sanctified and has insulted the Spirit of grace? God doesn't want us to take our sin as if it's nothing. It made Jesus go to the cross. Jesus gave his life. He was beaten. He became sin for us who knew no sin, so that we could become the righteousness of God. So it's really important that we receive what God did for us and take it very seriously, because without the blood of Jesus, we wouldn't be. In fact, it says right here, it says that we would be. How much more will the blood of Christ through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God cleanse your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? God is the blood of Jesus not only cleanses your sin, but it cleanses your conscience. So, Father God, I pray that as we seek the Lord today, that we would recognize and humble ourselves under your mighty hand, God, and seek your face and turn from our wicked ways, that we that you would hear from heaven, Father, our prayers and forgive us our sin and heal our land. God, I pray today. And Father God, I pray, God, that just as they entered into a covenant in 2 Chronicles 15:12 in the Old Testament, to seek the Lord God of their fathers with all their heart and soul. Their heart is their spirit. Their spirit, when we receive Jesus, we're born of the Spirit. Our soul is our mind, will, and emotions, which is our thoughts, our choices, and our feelings. So every day we need to be thinking about God. We need to choose to serve him, and we need to choose how our feelings, you know, stir up those feelings of thanksgiving and love for God. You just have to do that with your thoughts, your choices, and the feelings will follow. And God will do great works. It says, all of Judah rejoiced concerning the oath, for they had sworn with their whole heart and sought him earnestly, and he let them find him. So the Lord gave them rest on every side. So there's benefits of seeking God. He will bless your whole spirit, soul, and body. And he'll bless your home and your family. He'll bless, just like he did Israel. They were blessed. They had rest on every side. So, Father God, I pray that the people would repent today of their sins. Lord, I confess all my sins before you. I ask you to forgive me of anything I've ever done to anyone, Lord God. And, Lord, that you would cleanse me from all unrighteousness. And, Lord, I thank you for the blood of the everlasting covenant, that you bore my sickness and pains on your body, and by your stripes I was healed. And Lord, I recognize what your blood did for me in the covenant, Almighty God, the covenant we have with you, Almighty God. Through the blood of Jesus, I recognize your body that was broken for me, and I recognize the peace, the chastisement of my peace was upon you, and with your stripes I was healed. Lord, I don't take anything you did in the atonement at the cross just lightly, Lord. I take it very seriously, Lord. Lord, let us never trample your courts, Father God, or trample underfoot the blood of Jesus, because the blood of Jesus is our only redemption, is the only way we can be forgiven of our sins. So, Father God, I pray that our country would humble ourselves under your mighty hand, God, and pray and seek your face and turn from our wicked ways, that we would hear from heaven and that you would hear from heaven, forgive our sins and heal our land, God. Lord, I thank you for healing our land, Lord, and even on this day of this solar eclipse. Father, I thank you as NASA's sending up 3 rockets and CERN is doing some work, Father God, that they're trying to open up portals into the spiritual realm. Lord, I thank you, God, that none of this stuff phases you, Father God, because your church, Lord God, you said that coming back for a glorious church without spot, wrinkle, or blemish, Lord. And Father God, I thank you that your church is rising and shining in the earth, become a beautiful bride, Lord. Just as in Isaiah 60, you said, arise, shine, for the light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Great darkness would be upon the earth, but the glory of the Lord would be upon you. I know it's talking about Israel, but it says in Romans and in Galatians 3 that if we're in Christ Jesus, then we're heirs according to the same promise. So, and we've been grafted into the vine. So, Lord, I just thank you, God, that you hear our prayers. And, Father, you thwart the plans of the enemy. Whatever the enemy has planned for today, I thank you that those plans are thwarted. And that enough people, Lord, are humbling themselves and praying and seeking your face and turning from their wicked ways, that you hear from heaven and forgive our land and heal our land, forgive our sin and heal our land. Thank you, Father. I commit everything to you today in the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you all. This is Pastor Linda, lindacross.com, harvestchurchlive.org, and livinghopecfc.com. God bless you. Have a great day.